So there's a ton of product benefits, but the DFT being the third one, there are several different iterations of the DFT now. And as we mentioned earlier, the most recent one is called Burn. It's specifically tailored to people who are looking for weight loss. It has literally just launched. People should be receiving their Burn in the mail like tomorrow. So I mean, 100 pounds of weight loss, that's unbelievable. Congratulations, Mike. That's on the original products that weren't even designed to be used for weight loss. So for people who are looking for weight loss or weight management, which is maybe a better term even, you know, there's still more to come from Lavelle. And so there's gonna be some really exciting times coming up here with the incorporation of Burn into the original two products. So questions, please.
I have a question.
Yeah.
A comment and a question, actually. So I wanted to talk about Kids Thrive. So I noticed that hasn't been available lately. Don't get on my Kids Thrive. But at what age are they able to take regular? What do you think that's like, 18 or can a 12-year-old take regular?
We encourage people to use Thrive K, which is the kids formulation, has no caffeine, up until they're 18 years old. And that's, you know, because of the developing brain, we try to keep kids off of caffeine.
You could.
Most people who are pregnant don't get off caffeine anyway. So we always just recommend you talk to your doctor and make sure that the products are approved with them.
What specifically makes Burn work for weight management, weight loss, as opposed to the previous duo?
So the ingredient that's in several of the DFTs, it's called Forzoline, and it's an extract based on the Forskolin plant. And in clinical medicine, you know, what we use to see if something has efficacy is clinical studies. So we want to see that this ingredient was tested in a laboratory setting, meaning all these variables are controlled, versus this other group of people who are taking a placebo, so it doesn't actually contain the ingredient, and then we compare the results over a period of time. Forskolin has been shown in multiple clinical studies to help not only increase your metabolism, but also to help you preferentially burn fat as opposed to sugars. And so it can help you mobilize more fat from your body, from your frame, to use as an energy source. So with each of these evolutions of the DFT and now up to Burn, basically what they've done is they've been able to purify and create a stronger version of the Forskolin, which is the ingredient you'll see called Forzoline on the back of product packaging. So this is a 95% pure Forzoline. It's going to be much stronger. It's going to have more of that fat burning effect and help you to avoid eating mindlessly. You'll have a little bit of appetite suppression as well.
But not suppression.
Jason talked about the DFT is actually going to open up our pores.
It's going to open up what? Your pores?
He talked about that the Burn is going to open up the pores, so the product, as you're saying, it's more concentrated, it's going to get up there quicker. Mm-hmm. What is in there that is opening up the pores?
There's another product on the label called Cosmoferrine, and it's basically a black pepper extract, and it helps to dilate the blood vessels underneath the skin and the pores. Yeah, so I mean, again, I have to always tell people, you know, giving general advice is hard because you need to take it to your doctor, get their blessing, because I don't know anything else that's going on with them other than their, you know, current situation. So they may have medications or medical problems or something like that. So, you know, the answer to that is take it to your doctors and let them decide. But in most cases, yeah, they're fine with it. Yep.
So as a new promoter, I have a lot of people coming that is like filled with skin milk. And I know it's like not, or whatever, like what's your thing on that?
Education, basically. So if you look on the packaging again, you know, I'm an ingredients dork. I like to read the ingredients and see what's in there. There are a few types of caffeine. But that's generally a good thing because they all have different metabolic rates essentially, so the rate that, at which they're absorbed will be different. So again, to use coffee as the sort of the whipping boy here, you know, coffee has a really quick absorption, there's nothing really to buffer it, so it tends to give you quite a rush of energy initially, but it's also very addictive. So most people who drink coffee start off with one cup, and then pretty soon they're on to two cups, and then four cups. With Thrive, the caffeine comes from organic tea and a bit of guarana. And so tea has other ingredients. One's called L-theanine, and it's an amino acid, and it helps to basically buffer the effect of the caffeine. So it's got about a quarter, a third of the amount of caffeine as a cup of coffee. But the way that the L-theanine works is to make it be sort of like a smooth, slow-burning fire all day long, as opposed to this big rise and then a crash that you get with other sources. Yes?
Being in medical yourself, I have a lot of people that come to me and ask my opinion. You're a nurse, you take the product, blah, blah, blah. They ask for my advice, and I always give them the ingredients list, and I say, I can't say one way or the other, but please take it to your doctor and make sure that it's safe. And it's amazing how many doctors, physicians, you know, OB, depending on what their situation is, don't know of Thrive, nor do they know of the different ingredients that are in it, and their safe thing is just to say no. And I run into that a lot, and I don't, you know, obviously I can't say anything over a doctor, but I think it falls into the situation of lack of education, that they don't know exactly how these products are working, and I don't know how to combat that. And kind of not go around it, but, you know, how do I handle that?
That's a tough one. And it's true, you know, I went to PA school. PA school is basically an abbreviated version of medical school, but we have the same nutrition training, which is about a week. And it covers everything in the entire body and all the macronutrients and micronutrients in a week's time. So you really don't take much out of it. You know, I worked in sports medicine, so that I had a specialized take on it. Plus, I've been a nutrition dork and athlete for, you know, 25 years. So, you know, if you can find someone like that who has a better understanding than maybe your, you know, specialist or your family doctor or something, then that would be a good person to take it to. The way I see it is, you know, their job is to prevent something harmful from, you know, happening to you. So they sometimes play it safe, but they don't always have all the information. So again, if you can find someone who maybe has a better grasp of nutrition, supplementation, things like that, even sometimes just going to make sure that you're not going to have an interaction with something. And for that, I oftentimes recommend people go see a pharmacist, because that's basically their job. That's what they're trained for, is to recognize potential interactions. And then, you know, you can talk with other people as well. So, you know, people that you trust, it could be a dietitian, it could be a nutritionist, it could be a trainer at your gym who uses, you know, different or recommends different types of products. But I think really, you know, you just have to at some point decide if it's right for you. And ultimately that comes from talking to friends who have had good experiences. You know, I was hesitant initially when I started promoting because I didn't know what was gonna happen, but I've been doing this for over 4 years and I've never seen a bad result. So, you know, I have that confidence now where I don't care what someone says, I know what I've experienced and what I've seen. And that takes time, but yeah, that can be a tough one just because there is a real lack of knowledge of supplements. And so I think the trigger pull answer is just to say no. Hope that helps.
Seen a lot of sensitivity with people with blood pressure medications and heart problems, and specifically when they go to their doctor and ask, well, will this interfere with any of the medications I'm taking? Some of them will say yes, some of them will say probably not. Some of them even start trying it and then might start feeling some, maybe it might just be their prior experience, but they get a little gunshot. So they'll stop taking it, stop thriving off of the slightest little whim.
Yeah.
Is there any more that you might be able to add to the blood pressure aspect?
Legally, have been taking supplements, myself included, for an awful long time and never feeling a thing. And so when they take something and all of a sudden it works and they feel energy and they feel good, they don't know what to do. And that can be scary for people. Add to that, you know, some people's lifestyles and their diets have just been awful for years and years and years. And so once they start to make changes, you know, they may feel good all of a sudden and not know what that feels like. Or they may have an adjustment period as they get on the products, which is not uncommon. You know, some people just need to sort of wean onto it. It's just like anything. If you're going to start exercising after not having exercised for 20 years, you probably aren't going to go in and spend an hour at the gym. You're going to spend 5 minutes, and then 5 minutes a couple days later. You know, you need to just sort of take time and assimilate yourself. So yeah, I can't speak to the blood pressure thing, but you know, like I said, I've got the background. I've got the benefit of seeing literally thousands of people who have come on the products, and I've never seen any issues that were.
I've had some people that get gun shy after putting the patches on, and then they have a red mark, and they flip out thinking, oh my God, something horrible is happening to me. How can we explain why your body is doing what it's doing?
Have they ever worn a Band-Aid and peeled it off? So, I mean, first off, there's no latex, so, I mean, always make sure your customers know that there is not latex in it, because I get that question all the time, oh, I have a latex allergy, and, no, I mean, as I mentioned, the Cosmoprene in the patch that helps absorb the ingredients, it's a pepper extract, so, you know, it makes things hot, gives that flush, so, you know, it's a good thing, it means it's working, but people see that and they think it's a rash. I've never seen a true rash in 4 years of doing this. And whenever someone tells me, oh, I've got this person and they have a rash, I say, send me a picture. And it's never been a rash. So a little bit of redness underneath the patch, that's okay. You know, if it worries you, make sure you're moving it around, make sure you don't have any cosmetics on, put it on clean, dry skin. If you don't want to leave it on for 24 hours, take it off before you go to bed. There's lots of workarounds, but yeah, that's not concerning to me, and that's just what I tell people. Anybody else? Going once? Going twice?
One quick small one.
Okay, I did piggyback off her. I did have a customer that got some results in the niche for a few days, but I mean, she's loving her energy, so she's dealing with it.
Yeah.
We've gone through the ingredients. It's nothing that she's allergic to that she knows of.
Some people, I mean, just are more sensitive than others, and you'll see that with someone who needs one, you know, of something versus three of something. Just have to sort of experiment a little bit and, yeah, remove it sooner.
I also, just to interrupt, I also think it's the time of the year, because in the winter time our skin's more dry, so that could be another thing. Make sure they're drinking water, and just, it loves blood flow, so, you know, collarbone, the wrist area, the shoulder, you know, here, down by the ankle, so yeah.
Doctor. I mean, I can tell you that a lot of times after something like that, they're going to be put on a liquid-based diet that's high in nutrients.
There you go.
All
right,
well.
So I had someone become a customer, and he loved it, did it for 2 months, and then after, like, halfway through the second month, must have turned the pill packet over and freaked out because it said contained shellfish, and he's highly allergic to like shrimp and all that. So I was, and I said, oh, well, I was sad that I didn't even realize that. So obviously there's really, it can't be shellfish, right? It can't be like.
So some of the glucosamine that is in the products comes from shellfish, but it doesn't contain the protein that causes shellfish allergy. So it's perfectly safe for people with a shellfish allergy.
But we still have to.
Oh, he should text his doctor, absolutely.
You should always check
his
doctor.
Yeah.
I was just all right, so we're going to wrap up tonight.
Everyone's trying to get him in trouble.
We're going to do
good job.
I was just looking around the room after listening to Rob, and I'm like, wow. So I think it's definitely important. Anybody that's out there, Auto Bonus VIP. Can you all come to the front of the room?
Go. Well, I am, but I'm doing this camera thing.
So this is
you
want to
hold it?
So each and everyone has earned their VIP auto bonus. So everybody drives the car. You have two choices.
I'm the next
go girl.
I'm the next call group.
Oh,
elite.
Well, let me tell you, I'm coming after
they're
you.
They're like, why aren't you going up? I'm like, because she's going to call me next.
Yeah, okay. what Elise was talking about, the VIP, when you reach collectively of your team and your promoters overall, and you do $12,000 in sales, online orders with the Vibe experience, you have an option. You can opt out and take $300 of cash, which I did for almost a year. I did it in 6 weeks, and I had a nice car. So I took the $300, and I paid my car off, and then after a year, the Cadillac was calling. So I went and got the Cadillac. So, but you can pick a Cadillac, a Mercedes, an Audi, a Tesla, a BMW, and a Lexus, and they will pay you $800 a month. So for 27 months, I'm driving a car, getting paid for $800 a month. It pays for my car. It pays for my car insurance and many tanks of gas. Are you kidding me? So, yes. So, I'm just real quick. I only want you to do one thing. Tell me your name and how long it took you to earn your auto car. And what kind of car do you drive?
Holly Davis. I think it was 3 months. It might have been 4 months. And I drive Rico, who is my Mercedes
C300. What's your name, and what do you drive, and how long it took you?
Carrie Ann Tobin. It took me 13 months. Do not give up on yourself. Keep going.
Woo!
I had one TV, so I took the 300, and I'm about to go for the Escalade.
Upgrade!
Hey, everybody. Carol Sue, Lexus. RX 350 or 350 RX, I don't even know how to operate the buttons. It took me 45 days.
Awesome.
Heidi, BMW X1, it took me 4 months.
Christy, I drive a Mercedes C300. Stick it up my nose. Christy, I drive a Mercedes C300 and it took me 14 months.
Carrie, Lexus, her name is Lucy, by the way, Lexus 460, and it took me 53 days.
Okay.
It took me 11 days.
Woo!
Iron Mountain, my second month, and I live in Montana. I'm not a big luxury car guy, so I took the 300. I drive a Ford truck.
I'm Sherry, 7 weeks. I'm stashing it right now. Next year, I'm going to go for a Lexus.
Yay!
Awesome.
Jillian, 6 weeks. I earned it 2 weeks ago, and I'll be getting
Woo!
More.
Woo!
Rick, 7 months, and a Cadillac.
Nice.
Jamie, 1 year, BMW.
Nice.
Melissa, so I think it was like 8 months, and I have a Cadillac ATS.
Yep. Yay! Crystal LaBranch, 3 months.
Woo-woo.
I'm on my second Escalade.
Woo-hoo.
Her name is Black Beauty.
Oh.
My name is Nikki. I earned it in 7 weeks, and I drive a Mercedes.
I am Carol, and I earned my first car at 6 weeks. I drive a BMW. It's actually my second or third. I don't know. My husband also drives a BMW.
She's fancy.
And she's fancy.
Joe,
I'm so glad you're here. I noticed you, so I'm excited for you.
Go ahead. 2 months, I just hit it, so I'm dropping.
So you got also the $12,000 bonus?
Yes.
Woo!
Yes.
Yes.
That's my other bonus. She got a $4,000 bonus.
Yay!
So I'm gonna do the raffles real quick for the Newport, Rhode Island.
Quick
yep, and then before we leave, we'll do a quick video of all of us that we all love. Should we do Boston or Revere?
Boston.
Boston. Boston. Everybody, Boston. We'll get the.